welcome to another good news broadcast. It is good to be back, and it's good to know that the Lord has spared our life to be here another time. You know, we never know when the Lord may call us home, but we're here, made it through another week, and we pray that you will be blessed with the program. We have Brother Gilbert Scott and Gerald and Bill with us tonight. They'll be ministering to you in song and in music. And we have Brother Dockery here, and Sister Judy's on the telephone. So be sure and call in your prayer request. I want to thank each one who responded to my request last Saturday. I had asked everyone that would to send $1 to the Good News program so that we could get a count on how many people are watching the broadcast, and we're going to do this for 1 month. So if you're a listener and you're watching the Good News program and you haven't responded to the Good News program, I'm sure you could spare $1. If you would send $1 a week, we'll know that you're a listener, and we can add that to our count so we can know approximately how many people are watching the Good News program and where you're watching it from. This means a lot to us. And of course, we thank our regular sponsors, the ones who sponsor weekly. We appreciate them also. We're going to let Brother Gilbert and them go ahead and bring a song to you.
I have a source of strength when I am weak that takes me through when life is pressing me. I have a source of power from above. I'm covered over by a shield of love. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary, the precious bloodstain made there just for me. For all my sin, my sickness, and my pain, when I need healing, I claim the precious blood stain. How others makes it through, who do not go to Calvary as I do. For there the healing and the cleansing streams still flow, with peace that only God's redeemed can know. Claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary, the precious blood stains, they were made there just for me. For all my sin, my sickness, and my pain, when I need healing, I can claim precious blood stain. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains, they were made there just for me. For all my sin and my sickness and my pain, I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. When I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains.
is one of my favorite songs. I'm going to ask Brother Gilbert if he'll sing that song again, because Papa, a lot of people don't realize that we know about the cross. We know that Jesus died for our sins. We know that when they pierced his side with the spear, the blood and water came forth. And it's the blood that cleanses us from all sin and unrighteousness. But we fail sometimes to remind people that before he went to Calvary, when he was in the judgment hall and he was on the pavement, that they beat him with the cat of nine tails and 40 stripes he bore upon his body. What was those for? It was for the healing of all of our sickness and of all of our diseases. And I feel the Spirit of God moving in this place tonight, because I knew before I left what God wants to do. And if you'll be obedient unto the Lord, I know God can do something in your life. Go ahead, Brother Gilbert, and bring us that song again.
I have a source. That takes me through when life is pressing me. I have a source of power from above. I'm covered over by a shield of love. I claim the blood Jesus shed. Calvary, those precious blood stains, they were made there just for me. For all my sin, my sickness, and my pain, when I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. Do not know how others makes it through, who do not go to Calvary like I do. For there's the healing, the cleansing stream still flows with peace that claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains, they were made there just for me. For all my sin, my sickness, and my pain, when I need healing, I claim precious blood stain. When I need healing, I claim those precious blood stain.
Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. 1 Peter 2:24, and who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sin, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. David said in the 103rd Psalms, verse 3, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, and who healeth all thy diseases. Well, glory to God, praise God. Isaiah 53:5 says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes stripes we are healed. Jeremiah 17:14 said, hear me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for thou art my praise. And Jeremiah 13:17 said, for I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord. Oh, we're going to go to the Lord in prayer, because I know there's people watching this broadcast. You've got sickness in your body. You've got problems in your life. And I tell you, you come to the right place. We're going to obey the Lord. We're going to pray, and we're going to ask the Lord to touch you, and we want you to believe, because the scriptures that I've gave you is truly from the Word of God. Our Father in heaven, Lord, as we come before you, Lord, we ask you, Almighty God, to touch those that are sick and suffering in their bodies tonight, Lord. Father, you gave us the power and authority over sickness and the disease, Lord. You gave us the authority to use your name, the name above every name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. And Father, sickness has to bow. Cancer has to bow. Diabetes has to bow. Paralysis has to bow. Every disease, every name on earth is under the earth has to bow at the name of Jesus. And we ask you, Lord, encourage the hearts of those, Lord, that are suffering tonight in their body, Lord. We rebuke the sickness and the diseases, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And ask you, Father, that these stripes that you bore on your body was not placed there in vanity, Lord, but they were placed there to do the work that you came to do, Lord. We ask you, yes, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, touch them and heal them, Father. Touch them, Jesus. Encourage their faith, Lord. Let them believe in you, Father, for we trust and believe a miracle is going to happen right now in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, in the Lord. Name of Jesus. Bring us a song, brethren. Praise God.
When I see the sunrise in the morning, when I the sound of children playing, I know that it's all a part of God's amazing grace. Yes, I believe that there's a place called heaven. Yes, I believe. In a place called Calvary, and I believe there's a man whose name is Jesus, and I believe that he gave his life for me. I pray someday we might see this place called heaven. We'll see our friends and all of our family. We'll feel the power of 10,000 angels. They'll take our soul to be crowned at Jesus' feet. Yes, I believe that there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place called Calvary, and I believe that there's a place called heaven, and I believe that he gave his life for me. Yes, I believe that he gave his life for me.
Brother Gerald, go ahead and sing that song again, because I'll tell you why. I want people to get it in their mind. You've got to believe. You got to believe in this man called Jesus. You got to believe that he is the Son of God, the only begotten of the Father. You got to believe that he bore those stripes upon his body for the healing of all sickness and all diseases. He also suffered on the cross, and when they opened him with the spear, the blood and water came forth, and he paid the price for our salvation to cleanse us from all of our sin and unrighteousness. Now I want you to listen to this. I know, man, I believe. Go ahead.
It's when I see the sunrise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children playing, I know that it's all a part of God's amazing grace. Yes, I believe that there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place called Calvary, and there's a man whose name is Jesus, and I believe he gave his life for me. Well, I pray someday we'll see this place called heaven. We'll see our friends and all of our family. We'll feel the power of 10,000 angels. They'll take our soul to be crowned at Jesus' feet. Yes, I believe there a place called heaven. Yes, I believe in a place called Calvary, and I believe in a man whose name is Jesus, and I believe that he gave his life for me. Yes, I believe that he gave his life for me.
He gave his life for you. He gave his life for me. He gave his life for the whole world. Special prayer for Peggy Webb, prayer for the family of Evelyn Chapman, a song in her memory, Judy's aunt. Pray for Amanda, prayer for Ginger Bridges, she is sick. Prayer and a song for Roy and Audrey Hyatt, sing God on the Mountain. Like for you to remember Dorothy Hall, that's Brother Bill's wife. She needs prayer, she needs healing in her body, and we're trusting and believing that the Lord's going to intervene. Karen and John from Rock Hill is enjoying the program and praying for good news. Thank you. Sing God on the Mountain for Virginia Ward. Prayer for Taylor Lambert, for the Lord to lead her path. What wisdom. What wisdom to ask the Lord to lead your path in life. Prayer for Albert Stone and family. Mary Lou needs prayer for healing. Prayer for Beverly and Jimmy Colton. They have health issues and financial needs, and they also have a need for a service dog. Prayer for Ernest Earp for health, and prayer for Mary Earp, his mother. Claudia Rowlings needs prayer for family and friends. We want to ask you again to keep your mind upon the Lord. I believe the Lord is going to do something special through the Good News program tonight. There's a heavy anointing in this place tonight, and I believe God has something for you. There's a sweet lady. She's 93 years young. She was one of the ones who had fulfilled my request, and she sent a dollar, and she actually sent $4 for others who watched the program. And she says, "Please pray for my breathing." And she said she missed Sister Hazel very much, and may God bless you also, Pastor Varner. And her name also is Sister Hazel Shankle. So remember Hazel. God's blessed her with 93 years, and she needs a touch from the Lord. So we're going to let them go ahead and bless you in a song. I think Brother Bill's going to sing for you.
I'd like to say something before I do sing. My wife is having a battle, and we've been together over 60 years, and I feel like she's part of me and I'm part of her. And I'm asking all you prayer warriors out there to get on your knees and say a prayer for her. And we'll sing this song for her. "He Set Me Free," and that's what he's getting ready to do, is set her free from this stuff.
Set you free. He will, if you ask him to. If you're tired of the life that you're living and the devil's beat you up and you want out of it, all you got to do is call on Jesus, because he will help you. There's a lady who has asked a request, and I apologize that I don't see as well as I used to, but I know the one family is Atkin, And there's also a relative to that family who has had prayer requested, and Kathy's requested prayer for these relatives, and especially the one lady, she has cancer, and it does run in her family. But you know, it don't matter if it runs in your family or not. God is the answer to all of our problems. God has the answer. God paid the price, and the Lord is able to help everyone that will call upon His name. We just have to believe in Him. It's amazing, because the works that Jesus did, He went about setting the captive free, delivering the oppressed, setting those that were bound by demonic spirits, setting them free, healing sick bodies, straightening withered hands, people that were drawn over, He raised them up and they became straight and whole. He raised the dead. And Jesus said to His disciples, "These signs shall follow them that believe." Where are the signs? Back in the 40s and 50s, you saw the signs of healing. Ministers would minister the word of God. People would be healed and saved and delivered and set free and made whole. And I remember back in the early 60s, I was ministering in Kannapolis, North Carolina. And there was a lady there in that service. She was in her 70s. When she was 14 years old, she was helping her father cut fodder. And if they don't know what that is, they was cutting corn for the cows. She fell on a corn stalk and put out one of her eyes when she was 14 years old. She was in her late 70s, and in that service that Sunday afternoon, it was like that room had illuminated and had lit up. And that lady let out a scream, and she started saying, "I can see, I can see, I can see." Now you take someone that's 14 years old till they're 70-something years old, almost probably 60 years blind in one eye. God restored her sight in that eye that Sunday afternoon. And you can't tell me that God's not real. You can't tell me that signs and wonders still can't follow them that believe. He said, "In my name you shall cast out devils. You shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover." What's wrong, people? Something's wrong somewhere. Are we doing the will of God? Are we believing in Him? Are we living the life for Him that He can use us and work through us? Think about it. God is God, and God don't change. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. When I was probably 9 years old, I had something happen to my feet, and I couldn't walk. They did all kinds of tests, and they finally kind of determined that I had rheumatic fever. But one day, I was in my mother's house, and I crawled to the door, and I wanted to go outside. But I couldn't stand up, I couldn't walk. And something inside of me told me, said, "Go crawl over to the wood box, pull yourself up with the wood box." And there was a cross piece on the screen door, and I got a hold of it, and I helped myself up, and I saw that if I had something to hold to support me, that I could walk. And I want you to know that God healed me. And I've never had trouble with my feet and legs since then. They've been strong legs and strong feet. And you can't tell me that God ain't real, because He is. He still heals today. Praise the Lord. Go ahead, brethren, bring us a song.
I'll send this song out to Brother Jimmy Fox. It goes to our church. Prepare us a dwelling place there in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing. Melodious songs of the blessed, and
their spirits will sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessings of rest in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful. And the blessings that hallow our days in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet. Shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We want to send a special song out for Joyce Lackey, prayer for Audrey Hyde, and a song in memory of her mom and dad. Sing If I Could Hear My Mama Pray Again. Prayer for health for Donald, Jonathan, and Nikki. For Scott and Kathy Sigmund, they're enjoying the program and has requested prayer. Sing I Believe for Michael and Buster Treadway, and I know he's already sung that song. Ruth Tilly, prayer for surgery. Prayer for Tilly and Connor families. Prayer for our family and friends, for Curtis and Douglas Lambert. Prayer for the family of Jean Ware, and also let us remember Elaine in prayer. Karen from down in Concord has unspoken requests. God knows all about those, so we ask you that you lift them up in prayer. Rhonda Hicks has the shingles. Also pray for Mary. Pray for William Gwynn has cancer. Prayer for Paul has cancer. Prayer for a listener who has cancer. Angelia needs prayer for a place to live. Prayer for a listener's family who is in need of salvation. Prayer for Wes Dula, who is in the rest home. And Mary Gardner is enjoying the program and saying, I'm a pilgrim and a stranger. You know, if we get our life together and we give our heart unto the Lord and serve Him, He will solve a lot of our problems that we have in our life. We're going to let them bring another song, and then we're going to give out the names of those who have given on the broadcast last week and this week. Go ahead, brethren.
To all the folks who've asked for this, life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. Then things change and you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. The God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the bad times. For the God of the day, He's still God in the night. talk about faith when we're up on the mountain. A talk comes so easy when life's at its best. But down in the valley of trials and temptations, that's where your faith is really put to the test. But the God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He can make them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the bad times. And the God of the day, He's still God in the night. Yes, the God on the mountain, He's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the bad times. And the God of the day, He's still God in the night. Yes, the God of the day, He's still God in the night.
He's God all the time, 24/7. He's God. He never sleeps, never goes on vacation. He's always there. Prayer for listener for health, enjoyed in the program. Special prayer for Michael Adams, who's in the hospital. The Schrantz family, pray for Teresa Anderson, who's had an injury, and pray for a homeless person. Also, want to thank each one who responded to my request, and we want to carry this on for at least a month, so we probably got about three more weeks. And it is, what it is anyone who watches the Good News program, you have never donated to the broadcast, I'm asking everyone to send a dollar, because that will let us know that you are a listener and where you're listening from, and then we can have an idea actually of how many people are watching the broadcast, and to see, you know, really, you know, is it worth the cost and the time that we put here. I really need your response. I will tell you that altogether, that we got 45 letters this week. Out of those 45 letters, 31 of them was dollar givers, people who gave a dollar, who responded to our request. And some I hadn't heard from in a long, long time, but thank you. Thank you so much for responding. Thank you for letting us know that you're still watching the broadcast. Ed Boyd, who was a longtime sponsor of the Good News program, passed away, I think, the 25th of July. And I didn't know that until I got a letter from his sister. And thank you for letting us know. Many people who support this have probably done gone on to be with the Lord. And Brother Ed is gone. He was a faithful listener, loved the program. So don't forget, send in your dollar, so we can count you as a listener for the Good News broadcast. These are the ones that I forgot last week who gave on the broadcast. Lee and Linda from Morganton, Charmy from Mooresville, Kathleen and from Matthews, Karen from Valdez, Louise, also Dewey from Charlotte, Tim from Boomer, Jackie from Belmont, Vicey from Granite Falls, Ruth from Cowpens, South Carolina, Glenn from Pinola, Ernest and Mary from Lenore, yourself and Wendell Heath from Heath Springs, South Carolina, James from Marshville, North Carolina. Geneva from Hickory. Donald and Betty from Concord. Judy from Hickory. Barbara from Cleveland, North Carolina. Shirley from Salisbury. We appreciate our friends down that way. Need to hear more from our friends in Statesville, too. Francis and Sandra, they give every week on the broadcast. They are precious, dear people who loves this program, and we love them, too. Thank you, Francis and Sandra. Barbara from Krause, North Carolina. Sandra and Francis are from down in Waitsburg, North Carolina. Kathleen, we appreciate her. John and Shirley from Landis. Also, I want to thank each one who have given this week on the broadcast. This is not the ones who gave the dollars. This is the ones who gave a supporting donation. James and Ann from Monroe, North Carolina. Of course, Francis and Sandra from down in Wadesboro. We have Richard from up in Granite Falls. We have Louise from Gastonia. We have Donald and Betty from Concord. We have Gertie from down in Stanley, North Carolina. William and Elizabeth from Charlotte. We have Daniel from Mount Holly. We have Elizabeth from Pineville, North Carolina. Linda from China Grove. Also, we have an anonymous giver from Harrisburg, North Carolina. Edna and Richard from down in Matthews, North Carolina. And of course, we have Brother Gilbert and his wife, Margaret. We have Ed from Taylorsville, and also Bill and Dorothy from Taylorsville or Hiddenite, North Carolina. So we appreciate those of you who give on the broadcast, because without you, we wouldn't be able to be here. We're going to let them go ahead and bless you in another song, and then we're going to go into the message.
He's in the midst of our storm. He's in the valley we walk through. When two or three are gathered in his name, he will be there too. And when you feel so all alone, he will be standing next to you. He's in our midst, our God. As we travel down life's road, he will be with you all the way. And when we lay our head to rest, all the angels they gather round, we cry, oh Lord our God, he's always gathered in his name. He'll be there too. And when you feel so all alone, he will be standing next to you. He's in our midst, our God. He's in our midst. Into the prison they were thrown. Paul and Silas, they weren't alone. They knew their God was with them every day. But when the walls began to shake and all the chains just fell away, they cried, oh Lord, our God, he's always in our midst. He's in the midst of our storm. He's in the valley we walk through. When two or three has gathered in his name, he'll be there too. And when you feel so all alone, He will be standing next to you. He's in your midst. Oh Lord is in our midst. He's in the midst of a storm. He's in the valley we walk through. When two or three has gathered in His name, He'll be there too. And when you feel so all alone, He will be standing next to you. He's in our midst. Oh Lord is in our midst. He's in the midst. Our Lord, He's in our midst.
We had so many of the calls, so many letters on the dollar donations or the dollars that I didn't call those out, but John and Shirley Jackson, they also sent, and we appreciate everyone who has given on the broadcast. And I apologize if I didn't call your name out, but there's just so many of them, and we're limited for time. But thank you so much for all that you do for the Good News program, and I'm looking forward to hearing from you in the next 3 weeks. Praise the Lord. We want to know how many people are watching this broadcast. Now, if you've already sent your dollar, don't send another one, because that way you'll get double counted. We don't want no double counts. But we do want those of you who do your regular donations, go ahead and send your regular donations. We will know the other by the fact that it's a dollar. Praise the Lord. I've never seen a time in my life as it is now that there is such a heaviness in the world today. People are actually losing their minds, going crazy, not realizing the value of a life, just taking a gun and shooting them just for the pleasure of it, and not realizing that life has a value to it. And why do they do these things? Why are people heavy? Many are having burdens, financial burdens. And actually, there's a spirit of heaviness. There's a spirit of depression that's moving over the earth. Let me know one thing, that we are living in the last days. Many are departing from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, and we're told to turn away from such. But we're seeing it happen every day. People turning away from the truth, turning away from sound doctrine. And yet there are those who are suffering from depression, suffering from heaviness, because they can't meet their bills, or because they've lost a precious loved one, or some problem, loneliness. There's just a heaviness. But what do you do in the times like this? What do you do in the times when you're depressed, when depression comes? But David said in Psalms 34, verse 17, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles.
Amen.
Praise God. If you're saved, if you're a child of God, if you're living your best for Him, you're one of His. And David said that those are the ones who cry, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles. Now, David didn't say if the whole world cried, but he said the righteous cry. That means you've got to be saved. That means you've got to be into the family of God. You've got to be one of God's children.
Amen.
And God's children is being attacked. God's children are suffering along with those who are not God's children. And you can understand why those that are not God's children are having such a hard time and such a difficult time in their life and the experiences and all the troubles that they're having. This means that you need to be encouraged to call unto the Lord and repent of your sins and turn from your ungodliness and your wicked ways. And call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because everyone that calls upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved.
Amen.
And then when depression comes, when hard times come, when troubles come, when loneliness comes, you can cry out unto the Lord and say, "Oh Lord, Father God, have mercy upon me. Help me, oh Lord, in my stress. Help me in the day of my trouble, Lord." Yes. And David promised us that the righteous would cry and the Lord would hear us and deliver them out of all their troubles.
Yes, amen.
In the book of Isaiah, God said, "When thou passest through the waters, I'll be with thee. And through the river of the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, and neither shall the flame kindle upon thee." When these fiery trials of life comes our way, and we feel like that we just can't press our way through, but if we're a child of God, we can cry out unto Him, because we are the righteous of God, and He will hear us. He will hear you. I beg you tonight to cry out unto Him, because He will hear you. David was in a turmoil. David's life was not a perfect life. David had done some bad things and done wrong, and he suffered for it, but yet he cried out unto the Lord, and the Lord heard and delivered him out of all his troubles, and He'll do the same for you. David said in the 30th Psalms, verse 5, he said, "For his anger endureth for a moment, in his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning." That's the consolation we have in being a child of God, being saved, and being a part of the family of God. Peter tells us in the New Testament, 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12 and 13, Peter said, "Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. But rejoice inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's suffering, that when His glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceedingly joy." We're going to be tested. We're going to be tried. We're going to have these trials in our life as a child of God. But one thing about it, we have God on our side. If you're not saved tonight, who do you have on your side? Who's going to help you? Who's going to go with you? Who else but God can deliver you out of your depression and out of your troubles and out of the situation that you're in? Isaiah 61 and 3 says, "To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of gladness for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness." All that spirit of heaviness is over the land. And before we leave tonight, we're going to pray about that spirit of heaviness that's covering this land, causing the children of God to turn away and give heed to these seducing spirits and these doctrines of devils. We're going to help you to understand tonight, you need to turn away from them. Don't run to them. "But for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that He might be glorified." Also, when we go back to the 40th chapter, verse 31, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." This is what promises that we have in the Lord. Paul said to the Roman church, as he was teaching them in the 8th chapter of Romans, verses 38 and 39, Paul said this with a positive attitude, "For I am persuaded," now listen to this, we've got 4 minutes left, "For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Let me tell you tonight, you've got hope tonight. You don't have to stay in that state of depression. You don't have to sit and worry about how's this going to come about, how's that going to come about, how can I do this, how can I do? Just trust in the Lord. Paul said in Philippians 4:8, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. We've got about 3 minutes left, and we're going to pray here shortly, and then the brethren are going to come back and take us off with a song. And I want you to think about, where are you? Are you a child of God, or are you a child of the devil? If you're not saved, you're the devil's child. The devil can beat you up and do anything he wants to, and you can cry out and cry out and cry out and say, help me, Lord, help me, Lord, help me, Lord. But if you're not none of his, if you're not a part of him, he's not obligated to help you. The only way he will help you is when you pray a sinner's prayer and ask him to save you and forgive you of your sins. David said in Psalms 147:3, he healeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds. Do you know him tonight? Do you know Jesus tonight? Isaiah said in 41:10, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God, and I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. But Peter said in 1 Peter 5:6-7, humble yourselves therefore under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your cares upon him, because he careth for you. Come on, Brother Joe, we're going to pray. We're going to bind up this spirit of heaviness that's upon you, this spirit of depression that's come upon you. And if you're a child of God, you don't deserve that. You don't need that. We're going to rebuke that. If you're lost tonight, we're going to pray that God will save you before it's eternally too late. Our Father in heaven, Lord, as we approach the throne of grace, we take authority over the spirit of heaviness, the spirit of depression. We bind it up in the name of Jesus, and we take authority over and cast it down and cast it out. We ask you, mighty God, to move upon their lives, supply their needs, Lord, and loose them, Father. And Lord, those that's lost tonight, Father, we pray, God, that the Holy Ghost will convict their heart and save them, that they may become a child of God and find their deliverance in you, for we claim it done in Jesus' name. Amen. Go ahead, brethren.
Yeah.